Hey everybody, this is Nigel again, this morning, on Nigel Explorers. And what I'm presenting this morning on my little show floor, after my problem child fan a couple hours ago, this is a really, 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 really vintage fan. This is a Mathis cooler. And it is, well, they say that it's 20 inches. I guess if you go 20 inches from the foot there to the very top of the handle, it might be 20 inches. And this fan came out in the early 1930s. And for those of you that don't know Mathis, they eventually started making Curtis Mathis televisions. I actually had one. Of course, I wasn't born in the 1930s. If I was, I wouldn't be standing here right now. But I think I found mine at like Goodwill or when I first graduated from high school and then got into college or whatever. I had that TV for the longest time. If I had kept it, that TV would probably be worth money now and be a vintage television. But that was one of my first TVs that I ever had, was actually a Mathis, Curtis Mathis television. But anyhow, I'm rambling. So yeah, they started out with these fans and they made TVs and so on and so forth. So this fan came out about 1931. And it's extremely heavy. This is solid wood. I mean, this wood is very thick and it's very heavy. This fan weighs about between 55 and 60 pounds. So this is one of my heavier, one of my heavier fans, obviously. Everything on here is metal or steel. There are a couple of other models of this type of fan, however, they're half moon shaped, as I call them, and those are typically only two speeds. And on the metal grills here, you can actually move those left or right. This one here, you cannot move, they don't go up or down, so it kind of looks like they do, or they could, but they don't. And actually, one of these was actually half broke on the right side over there, and I repaired it, and I actually put some metal tape, so you can't even see where that solder broke off, and you can't see the metal tape. So the only thing that's wrong with this fan that I've noticed, or when I got it actually, is the handle on it, as you can see, is broke. And this is a 4-speed control. And the model number, obviously, as you can see on your screen, is 546. So you can see how it's kind of chipped right here. But I'm going to be getting that replaced. And very long cord. This cord, I think I measured, is about 10 to 11 feet long in length. I mean, it's just super, super long. And in the back, I'm going to do a walk around before I turn it on. The same thing applies with the metal grill back here. They do not move left or right. They are somewhat curved in that direction, in those directions already, so it can suck the air in from the back, I guess. And there is the motor. And there is the control unit inside. Now, these are not the same control modules as you see on Lakewoods and other newer vintage fans. This fan actually runs from the actual voltage currency for the speeds. And for those of you that are vintage fan collectors, you guys and gals know that these fans are very, very costly. For one, they're very, very hard to find, and if you do, these typical fans do run between $1,200, and I've seen them go all the way up to $3,700. I'm not gonna disclose my finances with my stuff, but it was not cheap. And I got it in very, very, very good condition. And the propellers in this one is there's six of them, and those are all steel. And it's very thick steel. If you stick your finger or anything in there, you are going to lose it big time. And you can actually kind of see the head of that. These actually almost are identical to prop propellers on an airplane. So that's very, very cool. And you can see how thick those blades are. Now, this fan is loud, just because it's really old. And I do have a bearing that is going out on it. So you'll hear some knocking on this fan when I start turning it on here in a minute. And that's what it is. So I'm in the process of getting that bearing replaced. This one here, I am not going to do the repairs on. I actually have somebody that I know that can assist me in that because I'm not going to like take this apart and fuck something up and then cost more money to get it repaired. So somebody, a friend of mine who knows very well how these fans operate, is going to help me take it apart and replace the bearings in it. But nonetheless, I mean, as you can see, there is no damage on it. I mean, there's going to be some knickknacks like this, and you're going to expect that. I mean, this fan is like way old. It came out in 1930, 1931, something like that. So I, for the condition that it's in, I don't think I could have found anything better. And I was specifically looking for something that was boxed, just because I am a box fan freak. But I don't necessarily like the half moon shaped ones of these. Just they're not as strong for one. They're not as heavy, and they only typically have two speeds versus the squared ones. The box ones are typically manufactured with four speeds. So you get more speeds with the boxed one than you do the half moon ones. So that's why I opted to look for this and I found it. So, and again, it is four speed. So there's a high, then there's a one, two, and then there's low. Very, very strong motor. I can't tell you exactly who made that motor. I did take this apart for cleanup when I got it. Like I typically do with all my fans, like I say in all my videos. I want to actually say that it was Mathis company who actually made the motor. I believe that's who did the motor as well. My bad. But anyhow, you can see how it's just crafted together all by wood frame. You can see the how they put it together inside over there, and I mean you can just tell. But yeah, this fan is very, very beautiful. It's very heavy, about 60 pounds. So anyhow, I'm going to start this out on low, and as it gets higher, you will start hearing some knocking, just FYI, and again, that is a bearing that's going bad on it, but I will be getting that replaced here in the near future. So anyways, let's start this out on low, shall we? Now you can actually kind of hear the knocking now. It tends to do it more on high, but I don't typically run this, and I'm not going to run it until I get that bearing fixed because I don't want the motor to completely blow up. So And let's go to two. And let's go to one. And let's go to high. Let's do a walk around. Now that's that knocking that I was telling you about, and that is a bearing that is going out. And let's do a SD. So the spin down time on this really, really old fan is very well. Again, I'm going to repeat myself. That knocking you heard was a bearing that's going out on it. So I'm not running this fan on a daily basis until I get it repaired, which will be in the near future here. But I did want to put that on my channel, on my fan show here, to show you guys another series of my collection that I have. So again, yeah, this fan is very heavy. It's about 60 pounds. It's solid wood frame. A very powerful motor. There's four speeds, six very thick metal propellers in there, and this fan is still running from way back in the day, and it'll run for another 100 years if it's taken care of. Like I said, I will be getting that bearing replaced in the near future, and I'll probably do a recap video sometime later on when I get that done. But you can see that the fan is in very good condition. It runs very well. No problems other than the bearing. This knob I can get replaced, which I am going to. I have a friend who has got connections for stuff like this, and I've already found a knob for this exact fan with the serial number and the model. And this fan, you can probably feel the airflow on this particular fan probably about, I want to say, 20 feet away. Of course, I wasn't standing 20 feet away just now, but I've had it running in my living room to the other side of my house, and that was about 20 feet, and I did feel the air all the way over there. So it moves a lot of air, and I'm very, very, very happy that I found this fan and at a reasonable price. This is definitely one of my beauties and one of my most favorite fans that I have in my collection. So if you dudes or gals find this, keep it as long as you can. They're very good fans, very heavy, very dependable, and Definitely a collector's item and definitely worth money if you ever choose to sell it later on in the future. But I don't have any intentions of selling mine anytime soon. So there you folks have it. I hope you enjoyed this fancy Matthews here. I definitely do. Absolutely love it. And I got it for a reasonable price, but most of these fans do run between $1,250 all the way to $4,000 I have seen. So they're not cheap. So anyhow, you guys have a good day. And again, I hope you enjoyed this video with my Matthews cooler fan. And subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And any comments, post below. Alrighty. Peace out.